Can you describe for you what the unique magic of Indian cinema is and what you think the future of the Indian film industry looks like at the moment?
I think the film industry in India is really poised for very great times. We must recognize that it is the country that makes the largest number of films in the world. We make twice the number of films that Hollywood does. And what is interesting is today Indian cinema has moved out of the diaspora into areas where people are curious. I'm not saying they've embraced it completely, but they're curious about it. And that has happened because the mainstream Indian cinema, Hindi cinema really, which is referred to as Bollywood, has suddenly caught the fancy of a certain section of the world, which is very interesting because I think as the world shrinks and becomes a global village, it is important to recognize that cultures must be understood within their own paradigms rather than yardsticks imposed by the West on the East. And so, yes, we have melodrama, we have song, we have music, we have dance. That's the way we tell our stories. And that's what we're presenting to the world. Not a rarefied version of it for a particular audience, because I think it's important that the cultural exchange between two countries should be both ways.
Talking about that cultural exchange, one of your recent projects, The Black Prince, was very much about those themes. Can you talk a little bit about that project and some of your other upcoming work that we should be excited for?
The Black Prince is a very interesting story about Maharaja Daleep Singh, who was taken away at the age of 5 by the British and brought to London, raised by Queen Victoria as her son. He converted to Christianity, he cut his hair, and he forgot where his origins were from. And then when he turns 25, he says, I want to meet my mother, who's Rani Jinda, who's the person that I play. When you first see her in the film, she's lost her empire, she lost her husband, she's lost her son, and you think that she's a pretty sad creature, but you discover that in fact she's an extremely feisty woman, and she has come there with a mission, and that mission is to tell her son that this is not your reality, you are a king, and you have to go back and seize the reins of the Sikh empire. It's a very powerful part, and I've really enjoyed doing it. It's getting released worldwide on the 21st of July. I've already won two Best Actress Awards for it, so I'm really looking forward to the release.